guys, so today's video is going to be, it's going to be quite a bit going on because I'm kind of doing a 3-in-1 video, if you like to call it that. The first thing I'm going to be doing is kind of a mini haul on Morphe brushes, just because I finally received my stuff from them, so I'm just going to show you what I got. The second thing is going to be kind of what I'm calling, is it really worth it? I want to start a new kind of series where I pinpoint hot new products or hot new brands that everyone is kind of talking about on social media or YouTube or whatever, and I want to tell you guys if I think it's really worth it or not, if it's worth all the hype, because most of the time it really isn't. We buy it because of the name, because it's new, because everyone's talking about it, then we come home, have it ourselves, and we're like, it wasn't worth all the hassle. So yes, that's what I'm starting. I'm going to be talking about that and talking about the Morphe eyeshadows and telling you if I think they're really worth it. And then finally, I'm going to be doing a tutorial using the Morphe eyeshadows and what I'm wearing on my face right now, if you look at my eyes. And yeah, I don't know if it's going to be a long video. If it is, get a cup of tea, as everyone says. Get in a comfortable position and I hope you enjoy. So I didn't pick up loads of stuff in Morphe brushes. I was just trying out because, again, it was my first time buying from there. I was a Morphe brushes virgin, so I'd never bought from there before, and what I needed at that time was eyeshadows and eyelashes. And their eyelashes, first of all, I picked up 4 pairs of eyelashes. I'm wearing a pair right now. These ones that I'm wearing right now, I don't know if you can see, I do show you closer when I do the tutorial part. I don't know if you can see. But these are the wispy ones. And when I got the wispy ones, they look so dramatic in the packet. But as soon as I put them in my eyes, they looked really natural but glam at the same time. So I am very happy with these and loving them. I also picked up these black, I also picked up a number 38 eyelashes. That's just those. These are, again, look so dramatic to me. I'm kind of a bit more skeptical that when I do actually put them on, they're not going to look that dramatic, but they look absolutely gorgeous. They feel so beautiful. Feel better than any kind of eyelashes that I've had before. So yeah, these are like my more dramatic eyelashes that I would wear. Then I picked up these ones. These are number 747L. I'm not sure if that stands for long. It might stand for long. Again, very dramatic, but these are just more fanny and they're not as clumped together and not as black as the other pair. So again, feel gorgeous. Like, they just feel so free. They're not clumpy, they don't stick together or anything like that. They just feel nice. The last pair I picked up was bottom lashes. I've been seeing quite a few YouTubers and other people using bottom lashes, and I was kind of like, let me try. I haven't tried them on yet, but I'm very eager to do it because I have literally no bottom lashes, and it kind of sucks because it does really complete the look when you've got nice kind of long bottom lashes. But anyway, that's why God created bottom falsies, and these are number 105. It just looks like that. Overall, I'm so happy with the eyelashes. I don't remember the price, but again, everything is in dollars on the Morphe brushes. Everything is in dollars on the Morphe brushes website that you can convert to pounds. So if whatever is in dollars is converted to pounds, and I don't think these were more than £2 each. Me, they were very inexpensive, but they are gorgeous. I'm obsessed with these lashes. The ones I have on at the moment, I'm in love with, so definitely take a look at their eyelashes. So the main reason why I went on to Morphe brushes and what kind of the whole video is about is the eyeshadows. And I picked up a Morphe brushes palette. I was going to go for the individuals, but I thought it was too much, there's too many colour options. But I thought, let me just try out a palette, get loads of colours and decide what I want with it. So it does come in a box and it was all nice and neat, but I have been playing around with it. So got the 35 colour warm palette, I believe it's called. First of all, that caught my attention is this beautiful mirror. Like, this mirror is so good. I don't know what you're seeing, what the reflection is showing you right now. You're probably seeing my messy room. If you are, sorry, it's real life out here. But yes, this mirror is gorgeous, and it comes with 2 eyeshadow brushes. I never use these, but if you you are someone that does use the brushes that come with the palettes, then there's two of them there for you. And then the star of the video, these beautiful eyeshadows. Spent £10, I think £10.21 to be precise, on 35 eyeshadows. £10. 35 eyeshadows. And what is more amazing about these eyeshadows, the quality is amazing. I'm kind of answering the question of whether I think it's really, if it is worth it or not, but the quality is amazing. You get all these beautiful shades which are perfect for autumn and winter, I think, because they're so warm and neutral colors, which is gorgeous. You can make about 10,000 colors, 10,000 eye looks just on this palette right here. If you are a beginner makeup artist, or you just love makeup like me, I advise you get something like this, because you can't go wrong spending £10. Like, there's nothing on something like this. It's amazing. It has matte shades, shimmery shades. Let me swatch. So like, oh no, that's too light. So let's see, like that. That's like one swatch, and look how pigmented that is. That is a matte shade, obviously. And then I'll swatch like a black shimmery shade. Absolutely gorgeous. That's just two of the colors, and I just know I'm going to love this palette. So in terms of answering, is it really worth it? Hells yeah. These are so blendable. There's such a range of colors on the website and in the palette. You just can't go wrong. And for the price itself, like, why wouldn't you buy it? Like, of course it's worth it. It's good quality. When people are talking about Morphe brushes and if their eyeshadows especially, it is worth the hype. They are not lying. Morphe brushes is doing it for me at the moment. So that is really it for the first two parts of my video. If you want to see how I created this eyeshadow look that I have on right now, then definitely stay tuned. If you're bored and you're thinking, nah, I'm gonna click off, then thank you for staying with me. So now that my eyes are primed, we are going to move on with applying the gorgeous Morphe eyeshadows, and I'm going to be taking this kind of matte brown shade right here, and I'm gonna mix that with this orange matte shade also up here. So I'm going to mix these two and just apply them to my on the crease, and not all the way up to the brow bone, but just slightly above it. But you'll see what I'm doing. But yeah, we want it to be lighter as it goes towards the brow bone, and then darker coming down. And I'm using this shade right here in the Morphe palette. I'm going to take this gorgeous kind of shimmery pink shade just here and apply that all over the lid. Next to it, which is like a nice goldy champagne colour, and I'm going to apply that to my inner tear duct. I'm going to go back in with the same dark, this brown matte shade, and then go back in with the darker brown kind of purplish shade right here, and just mix the two and then apply it to my crease. This gorgeous purple, dark purple shade, which is a nice shimmery shade to our bottom waterline. Eyelashes, I'm planning trying the Morphe Wsp Eyelashes, and they just look like that. Absolutely gorgeous. They look a lot more dramatic when you just see it like that, but as you can see on my eye here, they're actually not that dramatic. While I'm waiting for the glue to get a bit dry on my eyelashes, I'm just going to apply some mascara to my bottom lashes, and I'm using the Rimmel Extra 3D Lash Mascara. Just looks like that. Some liquid liner and make a small little wing. It for the eyes. I'm not going to contour or highlight today just because I don't really feel like it's necessary. I'm just going to conceal any of my problem areas, and to conceal today I'm using this MAC MatchMaster concealer. This is an 8.5. it's just like a concealer stick like that. And what I like about this, it's a medium coverage, so if you're wearing foundation on top of it, or either you're wearing this underneath the foundation, it just really helps to get a full coverage, and it is very buildable, so you can layer it up or just wear one layer. It all depends to you. But I'm just going to apply this under my eyes to clean up under there. And where else? Maybe around my lips. A bit on my cheeks areas. Down there. And a bit on my forehead. Just like a nice pinkish reddish tone. Using my favorite combo at the moment, which is lining my lips completely with the NYX lip liner in Cocoa, just a brown shade, and then topping it off with a NYX lip gloss in Beige. So if you made it to the end and you watched the first half of my video and the second part, and you saw the tutorial and everything that I was talking about in this video, I just want to thank you so much for watching, and definitely thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Make sure you leave me a comment down below. I will leave a link to the Morphe website down below and any coupons if they have any, just because it is really such a good website, and I really think that if you haven't heard about it or you haven't thought there's no reason for you to go on there, I definitely recommend it. But anyway guys, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate all the comments and the likes and whatever good feedback that you guys give me. It really does make me happy, and I would love if you continue to do that. And yeah, that is it, and I will see you later. Bye guys.